Hey, it's Mikey, and let's talk about Black Ops 3 and a fun class that you can use that will also help boost your KD. So this week, we went over easy glitch kills. Some people asked for more tips on that, so I have a link to that down below. We also went over easy fist kills, underwater kills, and the area denied card. Links to all that stuff down below. So let's just get into it. So here's the class setup. I guess the weapon really doesn't matter too much. I like the VMP, nice, solid, average gun. Quick draw, you gotta have quick draw, especially if, you know, maybe you don't have the best aim. It'll knock off maybe a split second. Helps you get the jump on people. And extended mag, it's just so great, especially if you encounter two or three people. You don't have the best aim, not the best accuracy. It has saved me many, many times. Extended mag, it just lets you be really sloppy. Ghost, it's just really a must have, especially if you have a short range weapon like a submachine gun. You gotta get in there, you gotta have ghost. Annie up. This class is kind of really for noobs, for people just want to chill, have fun. So Annie up pretty much knocks off. It gives you like a free kill. You start with 100 score, and we're going to be using that since we're using nothing but low streaks. The fast hands works with quick draw, so it's really great if, again, you don't have the best aim or the best reflexes. Fast hands is going to work with quick draw to help you get the jump on somebody or react a little bit faster. Awareness, that's really just a preference of mine. You can really use whatever you like, but I like it a lot, especially if you got a headset. An engineer is one of the must-haves in here. We're going to be using that a lot for re-rolling our care packages. So engineer and Annie up are the two big ones, I'd say. Ghost, if you have it. I already mentioned care pack. Here's the streaks. UAV to help us get to our care package. And once you got the care pack, then you got the dart. The dart easily can get you two kills. I went from hating this thing until now, you know, I really like it a lot. I like it a lot. Do not underestimate the dart. It will really improve your KD, okay? And to make things even way easier, we're gonna have combat focus, but you can only use that in certain situations. So let's get into how to even play this. So you can't just have this set up and be like, Mikey, where's my streaks at? You can't expect your score streaks to come to you. You have to play a certain way. We don't have any protection, okay? We don't have flag jacket. I mean, unless you want to put that on. So we really can't be too aggressive in capping the flags. You do have to be a little bit cautious, but you want to hover around the flags, kill the attackers, and if it's completely clear, then hey, go ahead and go for that flag cap. Capping a flag is just a bonus. Once you have your UAV, which should be pretty easy, all you need is 3 or 4 kills. Once you do that, then if you have the combat focus, call the UAV first, then pop in combat focus, and you'll get a nice little boost to all those assist points. Now, sometimes right away, someone may come along, you kill them, you're gonna get your care package and your dart very close together or maybe at the same time. First thing you do is you call in the care package. Do not use the dart, you know, waiting for it to fly in, because you're still gonna be flying and then your care pack falls, someone takes it, okay? So don't do that. Call in the care pack, see what it is. What is it? So let's look at the score streaks again. If it's anything, I'd say below a sentry gun, maybe a hellstorm, anything below that, reroll it, okay? Because you have a higher chance to get something better. But the sentry gun, Cerberus, and all those above, they're all pretty good. And I would keep those. I would not reroll any of them because you'll probably get an RC car, UAV, or something like that. But hey, that's just me and from my experience using this thing. All right, so from there, you can call in that streak, whatever it may have been, and then call in your dart. Now the dart. Gotta talk about this because I hated this thing. And the main reason why I hated it was because I didn't know what I was doing. I had no idea how to use it. So let's go into the dart and how to use that thing. And the first thing is look straight up before you launch it and just keep flying up. And I'm not looking at what's in front of me. I'm actually looking at the mini map. The mini map can tell you the direction where you're going. And I would say, I don't know, maybe 2, 3, 4 seconds of flying up. Then you can point straight down, hold the left trigger. The left trigger is going to slow you way down. And remember that the dart can target people running around, people in windows. It's really good. And you notice the crosshair changes once it targets people. And I believe you can probably get at least 1 or 2 kills just by shooting people. And then the dart itself, you use that to blow somebody up. And do not underestimate this thing, how maneuverable it is. You could just fly in and out of buildings. It can pretty much go the path that you can when you're running. And obviously you gotta remember to hold down that left trigger when you're flying in buildings, because that slows you down. Okay, so the dart is gonna get you probably on average maybe 2 kills, probably more actually, but I'm gonna send the low spectrum of things, 2 kills, that's already boosting your KD, whatever that care pack was. And then the combination of our setup with the ready up and the quick draw and all that stuff, it's just a great class. And using that setup, here's my 5 past games, 5.2 KD, 2.8, 3.2, 1.8, 2.1, and I'm not really trying my heart out or anything. I'm just, you know, playing normal. If I can, I'll cap the flag and stuff like that. But this is a nice streak setup. You don't have to go for GI units and motherships and things like that. This is a nice, chill way, stress-free way to build up your KD, and you don't have to, you know, sweat it out trying to get a Raps or a Hater or any of that stuff, okay? And actually, the score per minute isn't so bad either, now that I look at it. Okay, so you may want to have a version of this with Blind Eye or Cold-Blooded on, or maybe both, just for those moments when the enemy gets streaks, so that way you don't have to worry about it. That's someone else's problem. So definitely give this setup a try. I mean, it's great for newbies, people playing casual. I mean, it's fun for me if I don't want to feel like trying my little heart out, right? So this week, again, we went over easy glitch kills. That's another thing people kept asking for. Link to that below. Went over the fist kills, underwater kills, area denied card. Another one people kept asking. Links to all that stuff down below. What challenge or topic for Black Ops 3 do you want next? Leave a comment and I may get to work on that. All right, so on the left side there, we have more Call of Duty tips, tricks, info, updates. It's a playlist. I keep that updated for you. You can click on the screen or links down below. And on the right side, Ting. Ting is the pay what you actually use cell phone service. It's no BS fees, 4G service, new and used phones. And I've been using them for over a year before they even sponsored me. So I average about $20 a month on my iPhone. If you want to save hundreds of dollars a year, visit mikey.ting.com and they will hook you up with $25 credit that you can use on the service or a new or used phone. So if you want, you can use the calculator on their site to see how much your bill would be. That's mikey.ting.com. You can click on the screen or links down below.